did Adam die?
Yeah.
Did Jesus die?
Yeah.
You believe Jesus died?
Yeah.
I come from Tunisia. I don't come from a radical country. You can listen to everybody.
On the topic of the respect your mom. Should you respect your mom and unconditionally love your mom if your mom become a Christian?
Yeah, in Islam, yeah. Even if your mom, she don't believe on Allah, be like unbelievable on God. Yeah.
Living room versus wife to stay in the bedroom by herself so that she doesn't feel safe. That will freak her out. So and then she will start obeying the husband.
Then she, it's like it's a punish. It's a punish. It's small punish. And everybody they do it. Now.
And that's awful thing. That is very awful thing.
No,
to treat your wife like that. That's
it's better than to throw your wife out of the house.
I listen to you. So now I'm making my points. Let me gently encourage you to focus and listen, okay?
Yeah.
Third point, on the beating your wife. So, you read Arabic, you said you are from Tunisia?
Yeah, I can read Arabic.
Tell me the Arabic word.
You want me to take the...
Yeah, I want you to tell me the Arabic word.
Mm-hmm.
And then tell me how did you come to the conclusion, the way Arabic word is being used, it is just on a pillow fight version of the beat.
The version?
Like beating very gentle.
Oh.
Yeah, like in the, you know, when you watch movies, girls are fighting with one another with a pillow.
No, they do it, everybody, they do it. You know,
it's not about,
you're not living.
It's not about everyone does it or not.
Yeah,
it is, your book gives you right to do so. That's the problem.
There is solutions between the wives and husbands. So the wives can do like this to her husband and the same with the husband. So it's not the finish of all if the husband do this to his wife like a joke. It's like just like
so
joke.
Allah is making a joke in Surah 4 verse 34.
It's not a joke. That's what you know, step by step. You have to deal with the wife step by step. You have to advise her. You have if she don't change her behavior, you force her in the bed, you go in the living room. Then if she don't, you can hit her. It's not a hit, beat her. That's it, nicely. You can beat her nicely.
What is the Arabic word?
I must
tell you, how long have you been living in Britain?
What?
How long have you been in Britain?
Here?
Yeah.
Not long time.
Not long time. Over 5 days?
No.
Nearly a week? 1 week?
One month.
So,
I come.
Okay.
But
over a week?
I need
So you've been in Britain over a week, and you are justifying husband can beat the wife, and then you are saying, but in a gentle version. I must say that's very, very disturbing. You've got to give up that mindset. That's the first point. Second point in here, Allah is ordering you to do so. Okay? Allah is giving you right to do so. Why? Because you fear that your wife is going to be arrogant, disobedient to you. That's another point. Other point is, you express that you are Arabic speaker. Same Arabic word has been used in Surah 8 verse 12. In both of the verses, Surah 4 verse 34, Surah 8 verse 12, in both of them, there is no way, form or shape, you can say, oh, it is simply joking way husbands and wife are having conversation.
You know,
it's not a joke,
you know,
I know.
Know
I want you to know it's not a joke. The verse from Daraba. What is Daraba? What is Daraba?
Do you beat
your wife? Sorry. How do you beat a donkey? Do you gently like touch the donkey?
No one beat, no here. You have
do
you, to know.
Do you, do you, sorry, do you beat your wife with handkerchief?
No,
like
no.
This?
No, it's not like that. It's not like that.
How is it?
Some of it
do you give bruise?
Them like this. They can do like this nicely. It's simple hit. It's not...
Nice. So you beat your wife nicely?
No. If you ask me... No. You are talking nicely. No.
So Muslims don't want you to talk to me?
No.
Because they can't answer the basic questions.
I can't talk. I come from Tunisia. I don't come from a radical country. We can listen to everybody there. We can debate. nicely and peace in peace, so no problem. If you ask about the beat, you beat nicely. I tell you the sense of ayah. I tell you, it's not talk about that heat. If you think, it's not that violence. You hit your wife.
Doesn't matter. Behave her. Doesn't matter. No. If you break the leg of your wife or the bones of your wife or you simply slapped her, let me finish. Doesn't matter which form it is. It is already wrong. That's the first thing. That is taking the dignity of woman away. That's the first point. Second point is, in here, remember, first is your advisor, Habibi. I told you, don't do it. Second night, you went to the living room. You left your wife in her room that she feel unsafe and unsecure. And then you are beating her. Even in the context, it is not gently handkerchief touch. That's the point. And it is, as I said, so it is used.
Okay, I'm going to ask you another question. If the wife behaves so bad with her husband and you don't like to divorce her and or to be in separation with her, how he deal with her?
Also, so
when I ask you,
yeah, the question is if wife is
and
if
love
wife
her,
is dealing
love her and okay. He don't like to be away with her and
okay.
He want to leave with
let
her,
me understand
and he don't like to divorce her.
Let me understand. So yeah. There is a married couple, husband and wife, okay? Wife is not obedient, not very very nice wife. Husband loves her, but they don't want to get divorced. How do you deal with the situation? That is the question, correct? So, if in your mind, justification of the beating the wife so that you don't get divorced, that already shouldn't happen at the first place.
You mean that it's better to divorce?
I am Christian. I don't believe in divorce.
No,
I don't think. I don't think. I don't think.
Okay, you believe in
sir,
separation.
I am Christian, and my scripture doesn't give me right to divorce. You marry with someone, you die with that husband or wife you married. That's the point. But now, what you are trying to do is you are saying marriage is difficult. Marriage is hard.
I
don't want to divorce.
No,
let me finish. I am listening.
If the wife, she don't behave nicely, or if the husband would say, so what the solution? What's
they go and see the marriage counseling.
One minute.
They go and see the marriage. No. Solution is not
you
husband comes
her,
and with
you
the wife.
You have to advise her and to clear her. You did this wrong, it's right, it's wrong, it's right. So then she will know, she concludes that her point. If she don't confuse and she don't stop, you know, sometimes in the name of feminism, they don't respect men.
So
they
for her to be obedient wife, you think it is necessary? I'm trying to understand you.
Yeah.
So you think it is necessary for her to be godly wife, she needs to be beaten by her husband if there is a problem in the marriage.
In Islam, the wife is not enemy. It's not enemy. It's not enemy. The Prophet before he died, he said, "An-nisa ushaqa'ukum rijal." The wives is the sisters of brothers, and in Arabic it's more means than what I say now, or that translated in English. So
in his last sermon, listen. In his last sermon, Muhammad compared women like animals.
No.
Yes, I can show his
you
last sermon.
Proof.
Yes, I do have a proof. And it's not only that, let me, since you try to justify, yes, it's okay to beat the wife. Now let me give you the proof how your prophet thought it was alright to beat the wife.
From Quran.
And your prophet, life of your prophet is not in the Quran, it's in the Hadith.
No, I tell you.
And then also, I am going to give you reference.
The Hadith, you know, there is a criteria in
listen,
Hadith.
Listen.
Not all the Hadith is right. I tell you,
yeah,
when
that's
you ask
what Saudi Prince is
start,
saying. Yeah, that's what Saudi Prince is saying. Get rid of the Hadith.
No, it's not a criteria, Arabi Saudi. You know. They don't know who support Israel. I don't believe on that. This is Saudi Arabia. No. The Hadith have some rules. It's a science. So
I'm going to give you Sahih Hadith. No worries. I'm going to give you Sahih Hadith. So that you don't run away, okay?
You ask me first. You tell me what you're following. I tell you I follow Quran. Follow Quran and Hadith.
You can't follow Quran. You said you do the follow the Hadith as well. So now listen this one.
How I follow Hadith?
This is Muhammad's last sermon. Okay, I've got the pictures of here. First, I'm gonna since that first came, I'll read that to you. Okay, listen.
Not
treat your woman kindly. That's
kindly.
Very nice. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
They they are like prisoners in your hands. Your wives are prisoners in your hands. Treat them nicely.
You think then he changed his mind and should he said, they, I am your sister and you look after
should
them?
Should they be guilty of flagrant misbehavior, you may remove them from your beds and beat them. That's his last sermon.
How can happen? When he say Fatima is the jail of my life, he talked about his daughter, and he talked about his wife. He was joking with her. He was playing with her.
What kind of play Mohammed was doing with his wife when he was beating his wife? What kind of player Mohammed was having when Mohammed climbing the top of a child?
No one can believe that a prophet can beat his wife.
Okay, listen.
You know, no one can believe that.
I know.
But
so,
he was...
Listen this one. So, Aisha is speaking, okay? Aisha is speaking. So, if you don't believe that, you don't believe the mother of the believers, as well as you don't believe in your prophet.
It's not about what,
listen. He struck me on the chest, which caused me pain. Sahih Muslim 21:27. He struck me on the chest, which caused me pain. He struck me on the chest, which caused me pain. Can you make sense of this? Sahih Muslim 21:27. We already identified the hadith as the Sahih because already it's in the Sahih category. Okay? Have you got it?
Here in Sahih Muslim they are corrected and they say the Prophet in his life never ever hit a human. Hit someone, even you know.
So Aisha wasn't human.
How he can do it with his wife?
So you believe Aisha wasn't human? If your commentaries are saying Muhammad never beat the human in his life, are you telling me that Aisha is not a human?
No, she's a human.
Okay,
she's
so
the wife. Of
so
prophet,
is
so
Aisha lying?
She's a human. As
is
well.
Aisha lying?
Is a liar.
Yeah, is Aisha liar?
No, she's not a liar.
Okay,
she's
if Aisha says, if Aisha is human. And if Aisha, as the mother of the believers, is not liar, Aisha says, he strike me
Give
on
me
the
reference.
Chest. Sahih Muslim.
How I can believe?
I told you.
I
Sahih
tell you,
Muslim.
Sahih Muslim, correct that what you say now. Correct and say that.
No. Sahih
the prophet
Muslim.
Cannot
no.
touch no human in his life.
No.
Even the one who she killed his uncle. If you know the history.
Let me tell you something.
Can I explain to you something?
Let me make something very clear. Those kind of your kind of nice approach is not going to work on me. You are accountable for the teachings of your prophet, as well as Muslims are practicing those such a things. Okay? Sahih Muslim, pick up your book.
Yeah.
Go to the hadith number 21:27. Sahih Muslim 21:27. Have you found the hadith? So if Aisha is human, and if Aisha is not lying, she's correct that your prophet beat her. Okay? So I want you to... Did you find the hadith or do you need help? Do you want me to find the Arabic one?
No, where are you?
2127. Read it to me, sir, and then explain it to me.
No, I tell you how they are talking about it.
What is it? Tell me, what is it?
They corrected it. Yeah.
What does that mean? They corrected. I don't want you to go to the Sheikh Google.
Yeah,
I don't want to go to the Fatwa 164.
Listen,
164-260. Yeah. That is Islam QA. So you went to Islam QA. Someone is asking the Islam QA. I don't want you to go to Islam QA. Okay, I can see the website. Look, it's on the top.
Corrected, yeah.
So what is it saying?
It says they are telling that
that the Prophet he put his hand on here on the chest of his wife, and he do like this.
So it says Muhammad put his hand on her chest, yeah, and then do this thing.
He do it like this.
Don't touch me.
Sorry.
That's fine, don't touch me, but that's fine, okay?
Sorry. Last time I show you
So Muhammad touched her chest, yeah. Okay? Aisha says, he struck me on the chest, which caused me pain, okay? So the way Muhammad struck her...
I'll tell you that.
Listen,
fake hadith.
It is already Sahih hadith, and then you went to Islam QA.
I tell you that they correct it, and they say, his prophet, he cannot beat humans. Never.
So, If Islam QA tells you Muhammad is a prophet, therefore he cannot beat humans, okay? Yeah. Then I am coming to the conclusion Islam QA thinks Aisha is not a human. Okay? If Islam QA thinks Aisha is human, listen.
Hamdi from Tunisia.
Oh.
Hello.
How are you?
Fine. Have you read the Bible in Arabic?
I read it. French.
Hello.
How are you? I'm good. Thank you. How are you?
Yes, I'm not too bad. Thanks. Yeah, Hamdi was in Slough High School.
Okay.
Last Tuesday.
Okay.
And
I took the Bible. So I read it.
So anyway, sorry for interrupting.
Okay. Thank you, John. Thank
That's
you.
But she'll tell you the right way.
Oh, you.
Jesus is the right way. So, hadith simply says.
Okay, John.
Sahih Muslim.
Last Tuesday I talked to him with the John, the other one.
So Sahih Muslim hadith simply tells you Muhammad with his wife, okay? Strike her in the chest. It's not like touched her gently on her chest, but strike her on chest, which she was like, oh, it hurts now. Okay? It caused her pain.
I clear you.
Listen.
I clear you. I'll be honest with you. I clear you. It's a fake hadith. They corrected it.
So Sahih Muslim is fake. Who corrected it?
In Sahih Muslim, they say it's fake.
You are lying.
You are lying. You know you are God, you are lying. You are lying. I just translate what they say here. That's not from Sahih Muslim. That's not from the Arabic website. I'll show you. You tell me, translate it from the Arabic. I translate it. The website you went called Islam QA. That's not Sahih Muslim, okay?
They are expert of deception.
And from the beginning, I tell
they are
you,
expert of deception from like the your God,
you
and then they do
the
same thing.
Following. I tell you, I follow Quran, I follow the Quran, I follow the Quran, so I'm clear with you.
But in the Quran, Allah gives you right to speak your mind. There is hadith.
If you want to talk about hadith, it's not easy. You have to know the Arabic language. You have to know the, because it was not memorizing in the papers. Everything in the papers, there was remorsing, memorize in the heart of man, like we say, in the memory. Maybe
Hamdi,
I don't know.
I want you to look at my face right now. Yeah. This is the face you will see every time when you hide behind the magical Arabic language, okay? It has nothing to do with like, oh, you need to know Arabic to understand the hadith.
No, no.
It doesn't work like that.
No.
There is,
it's not easy because...
I can see you are playing the game of denial.
What's the miracle inside the Quran? What's the miracle?
There is no miracle.
The language.
What language is miracle?
No, if you know if you was born in that society, in the Arab, that in that time, that period of time, you know, it's not easy. You can't make it. Even all
you
the
can.
Arab...
No. In 7th century Arabia, people were expert on
If you know the
poets,
poets, if you know the...
Yeah.
No, you can't.
There is a woman called Asma bin Marwa. Her poem was
Arabic,
so beautiful, she got
they
killed
can make
for it.
No, never. I'm Arab. And I can teach the Arabic language. I know it. really, I know very well the Arabs. No one can make it like that.
Let me deal with that. Let me deal with that. Have you got the Bible with you? On your phone, have you got the Bible? So on your phone you don't have Bible, okay? I'm going to show you. I want to show you something in Arabic, okay? So that you don't hide behind Arabic anymore. So now you become hadith denial. I'm gonna find your Bible in Arabic and I want you to read it. My name is Hati.
Sati.
Hati. Hatun.
Hatun. Maybe I don't speak English very well.
No, your English, no. Your English seems to be okay to deceive you enough, but I haven't fallen into it yet.
I misunderstand many things, but I can't tell you. If you talk Arabic, maybe I can.
This magical Arabic language is not helping
you. No, it's not. If you know the true Arabic, it's more rich. Here, the English, you can say the word for only one thing. There, the only one thing can be with 10 and 20 words. It's not easy to make it.
Here's the thing I don't understand. Listen to me. Here's the thing I don't understand. If you are beating someone, that is already awful thing, okay? If you are beating someone in English language, if you are beating someone when you live in Saudi Arabia or when you live in Pakistan, the action you are doing is very ugly. Doesn't matter which language you use to do practice that violence.
If someone wants to do violence, he can do it in name of everything, in name of Islam, in name of Christian, in name of Jewish, he can do violence. Sorry, even here there is a violence, not only in Arabic, Saudi,
but your Pakistan. God is encouraging it. Your God, yes. When your God tells you to beat your wife, is that the encouragement of
it's
the violence?
It's in harmony with the human psychology, so, you know.
Okay, so he's
if
the...
I'm sitting nicely now with you, can I talk? Hatun, can you hear me?
I'm listening,
if I'm,
sir.
If I'm sitting nicely now with you, I might come and I don't do wrong and he attack me.
I want you to read this for me.
Okay. الرب راع فلا يعوزني شيء في مراعى الخضر يردني الى مياه الراحه يهديني رد نفسي يهديني الى سبل البر في اسمه ايضا اذا سرت في وادي ظل الموت لا اخاف شرا لانك انت معي عساك وهكذا كما يغر يعزيني فاطر قدامي نائم بسحب بده راسي كاسي غير عندما خير ورحمه يتابعون يا من اسكن في بيت الرب
Don't you think this is very beautiful?
No, I say
do you think it's beautiful?
Arabu Ra. So we talk about that God.
No. Do you think as you read it in Arabic, do you think it's beautiful? No.
In Arabic it's normal. There is no there is a sense, but a sense it's normal. So in which I can say it. It's say Arabu Ra. In Arabic, so Arab Ra is Allah is
God is my shepherd whom
yeah,
I shall fear.
Yeah, the shepherd, you are right.
So that's beautiful thing. Psalm 23, in Arabic it is beautiful, in English it is beautiful, in Hebrew it is beautiful, and meaning is beautiful. So therefore, for you to come to me and then say, Quran is Arabic miracle,
this sense is nice. I have no problem with the sense. I tell you about the miracle. If you read the Quran in Arabic, and if you know the true Arabic.
I listened to Quran in Arabic.
No, it's not about listening.
You know, I listened to Quran in Arabic once, and my dog had to run out because she freaked out. Even my dog ran out from listening to Quran.
You have to spend 20 years to understand the true Quran text. You can't. You know, it's not easy. Even me. No. If you want to know the miracle.
I'm not following. Are you with me? Come to the world. Okay? So you are not listening, okay?
I'm listening.
Beating someone in English language. beating someone in Turkish language, beating someone in Urdu language, it is still awful. It is still wrong. Doesn't matter. Therefore, Arabic is a miracle thing,
it's
not working.
No, if you ask me, what's a miracle? Even the Bible, many of people, they're following me. Even Arab as well, they're following the Bible. So, in different language. Quran in different language. But if you ask me about the miracle, I tell you the miracle of Quran. Of words.
Words. Like, how can beat is a miracle? How can kill is a miracle? How can chop their head off is a miracle? How can crucify them is a miracle in Arabic?
I don't get it.
I don't get it.
What is that? They were living in Jahiliyyah, so they were living in a fight. So everybody fight. It's not only in that Muslim countries, even here in Europe.
Hamdi, let me tell you something. Let me tell you something very serious, okay? I can see that you are intentionally just hiding behind this. And oh yeah, it's all lovely. Quran is by itself, it's all lovely.
Yes, I can see
you are trying to do that, but here's the bottom line.
Many values in the Quran, it shows you how you have to defend yourself sometimes.
There is no value in the Quran. There is no value in the Quran.
The solidarity, the mercy, the love, the respect, the respect of parents.
Let me break it down and then ask you very basics, okay? Okay, this on the topic of the respect your mom. Should you respect your mom and unconditionally love your mom if your mom become a Christian?
Yeah, in Islam, yeah. Even Islam. If your mom, she don't believe on Allah, be unbelievable on God. Yeah, wallah,
you are smiling and you are lying. Give me reference. You can still love your mom and your mom becomes apostate.
The parents in Islam is something worship. Even if they do wrong, you are not allowed to.
If your mom becomes apostate, yeah. She should be killed according to Islam. How can you love her?
Never, ever. You are not allowed to go back with your parents. Even Sahaba, they were with...
In your dreams. In your dreams. That
I give you the reference.
Give me the reference.
1 minute.
You're a shit. You're a shit. I don't see the left. 1 minute. You can mock, but mockery
and we also turn over.
Shukran. I find it's amazing. Every Muslim is coming and then telling to walk away from me.
No, to be honest with you, I'm coming here the first time.
Oh, and Muslims already picked you up and they don't want you to talk to me.
No, I want to talk to me. I want to talk.
Your Muslim brothers don't want it. That's absolutely fine. Give me the reference. So, answer I am waiting is, can you love unconditionally to your mom if she become apostate?
The lowest valley and leave you there. He will leave you there. But Jesus, he will come
look,
down.
Look, I can give you.
What is that?
The surah is Luqman. 14.
Surah 14?
14 of Surah Al-Luqman.
Let me find it. Let me find it.
Wawassayna.
Let me wait.
Yeah. I can't translate it.
No. Let's find it. Surah Al-Luqman. Which one is that?
Jesus, God will have mercy on you.
Is it in the beginning or towards the end of the Quran?
Luqman 14.
But I don't know which chapter is Luqman is.
L.
What is the chapter before that?
Luqman 14. Put it then I'm going to...
What surah comes?
I'm showing you. Yeah. Quran, Surah Luqman.
Surah?
Yeah, Luqman.
Surah 14.
Yeah.
No, that's Ibrahim. Surah 31?
No, somewhere.
Yeah, Surah 31, verse 14. Okay. Yeah, read it to me.
وَوَصَّيْنَا الْإِنسَانَ بِوَالِدَيْهِ حَمَلَتْهُ أُمُّهُ وَهْنًا. We advise humans to look after his parents in this sense. You read it. Yeah. حَمَلَتْهُ أُمُّهُ وَهْنًا. His mom, she get pregnant with him and she get tired. عَلَى وَهْنًا. وَفِصَالُهُ فِي عَامَيْنِ. فِصَالُهُ is like she can't stop feeding the milk. It's called فِطَام. She feed him from her boobies, she gives him milk, then she can't stop after 2 years. And أشكر لوالديك المصير وإن جاهدك وإن جاهدك. Even if they say, don't believe on God, even they stop you believe on God, وصاحبهما في الدنيا معروف. Don't fight them. You find it.
Let me read it?
Yeah.
So it was all fine, until you end the person. Listen. We have enjoined upon man for his parents. His mother carried him in weakness upon weakness.
Yeah.
And his wearing is in 2 years.
Yeah.
Be grateful to me and to your parents. To me is the final destination. So where is the part? Yeah. Where is the part where you were forcing? Listen, where is the part where you were forcing? If your mom is apostate, you still need to love her unconditionally.
I tell you, even if they stop you believing on God, you are not allowed to punish them.
Give me the reference.
Yeah, I give you.
No,
give
your you. Reference. I give you. It's your reference. Reference is for good Muslim woman.
No, it's an Arabic.
What is my question?
You ask me, are you allowed to hit or to beat or to, I don't know, or to kill your parents when they don't believe on Islam or Allah? I tell you, not only Islam, even if they don't believe on God, ever.
Okay.
You are not allowed.
So
now, it's something
I can see you understood my question. Okay? So, my question was, can you still unconditionally love your mom? Can you still love your mom unconditionally if your mom is apostate? Okay? I am waiting you to give me the verse. Surah 31 verse 14.
I explained to her.
I'm not Muhammad. Muhammad is crazy. I'm not Muhammad. I never swear of Allah. I gave him compliments. Don't you like Muhammad? Sensitive feeling. Sensitive feeling, sir. Actually, Muhammad is already dead. You need to grow up.
My man came also the resurrection of the dead. For as in Adam all die, even so in Christ shall all be made alive.
Last question.
Can you love your mother? Now here we are told that blind man
came not allowed to
death. Death came into the world by man. Our first father, our first parents brought death.
Islam is very, very dangerous ideology. I can see the brainwash you've been through. You don't even want to engage in proper conversation. Let me ask you a basic question. What do you think that the Prince of Saudi wants to get rid of the Hadith?
He can do what he likes.
He can do what he wants, okay?
Messenger.
So it's all right to get rid of the Hadith.
He represents his own himself.
Himself.
Even this one, he can do one, the other one. So there is a rule. There is a criteria outside.
Headquarter of Islam, Saudi Arabia, where millions of Muslims go for Hajj, make them to make money, and they identify themselves as the country which follows to Muhammad.
If the hadith,
they are getting rid of your hadith, customs of Muhammad.
I tell you, 1 million times, all the hadith
is the same. There is life.
I know. Saudi Prince agree with you. So,
excuse me.
Saudi Prince agrees with you.
The word of God.
Can I ask you a question?
No. The devil lies to our first parents.
So,
question is,
so, can you love your mom unconditionally?
No, he's respectfully.
The Holy Bible. My question is the word of God. I suggest that
you love your mom unconditionally if your mom is apostate.
I tell you, I give you the reference. Even if I don't believe in God, you're not allowed to do that.
Verse doesn't say that.
I give you.
Verse doesn't say that.
Verse doesn't say that.
Verse doesn't say that. Verse doesn't say if your mom doesn't believe in God.
No, he's talking about parents. Mom and dad. It's not about both of them.
Are you allowed to love your mom?
I tell you, I give you another thing. If you understand,
the resurrection of the dead. As in Adam, all died.
Show me the verse. Even she doesn't believe in Allah.
Because in Adam,
so now your Arabic Quran is different from this Quran. No, let's show me. Show me. I'm going to expose you. So show me.
Even if they fight you and they tell you don't believe in God, you are not allowed to fight or to eat or to punish your parents in Islam.
I am the resurrection and the life.
Show me the verse.
For his parents, his mother carried him in weakness, upon weakness, and his winning is now in 2 years. Be grateful to me and to your parents. To me is the
son.
Your
Quran is different from
no,
this Quran.
Yeah.
That's why not the whole human race
are they different or not?
No, no, they do it.
Until Jesus Christ breathes new life.
Let's just move over there.
And they are brought alive from the dead. As by man came death, so by man came also the resurrection. As in Adam,
the human
man
is in his parents, his mother's, and their own weakness and winning in 2 years to turn me and your parents to self-determination and that they strive to involve me. What you do not work for them will not follow this way. So even if they tell you, Jahadaka fi is meaning in Arabic, even if they tell you, don't believe on me, on Allah as well. Even if they tell you, don't believe on me, you are not allowed to punish them. You are not allowed. You just sahibhum of the dunya ma'ruf. So be gentle with them. Be nice with them. It's the right of them. To be gentle and be nice even if your parents are bad.
So when your mom becomes apostate, according to Islamic teaching, she should be killed. Listen. According to Islamic teaching, she should be killed.
No. This is, I tell you, I show you the right Arabic Quran. I tell you.
This Quran is different than the Quran you are reading, therefore this Quran is wrong. But let me come to the bottom line. So in Islam, if someone leaves their religion, they should be killed.
Too many Qurans.
Listen. Yeah. If your mom leaves her religion, according to Islam, she should be killed. So if you need to be loving and gentle towards your mom, is that means you kill your mom in a loving way? How does that work? How do you kill your mom by loving way? So do you just chop her hand off, or do you kill her faster than ever that she doesn't feel that much pain?
No, there is no punishment in all of them. No punishment. You can't punish your parents. It's not love.
If your mom becomes apostate.
Oh, apostate, yeah.
So what happens to her?
I tell you, you can't do nothing. Oh, what's happening to us? Allah will know.
So let me tell you something.
1 minute, her behavior is not acceptable in Islam. But even who they don't believe in Islam, we don't say that we're going to hell. To Jahannam. No, don't say that. Because in the day of judgment, only God knows. No, Allah knows.
So it seems to me that Allah fails to know that.
So maybe this world is wrong.
Listen. it seems to me that Allah failed to close that, because Allah already makes it. Allah already expresses.
That is why we rejoice today, because we know that the whole world lies in the wicked one. The whole world is under the power of the god of this world, Satan, the devil. And Jesus Christ came to overcome the devil. Jesus Christ came to take away from the devil that power.
According
to
the teachings of Islam,
and in
okay.
Jesus Christ,
doesn't
we see
matter what position,
death,
what place, what hierarchy you have, the moment you deny Allah and Muhammad, you are identified as apostate. And according to the teachings of Islam, according to Sahih Hadith as well as Surah 4 verse 89, you should be killed. So therefore my basic question was to you, if you love your mom unconditionally and then you need to respect them unconditionally, how do you deal with apostasy law when it comes to your mom? And what you've done is you just circulated around, and all you've done was pointing out Allah is really, really bad. But beside Allah is very bad. Listen, no, listen. Here's the bottom line, there is a problem. And you are in a big problem.
Allah does say that.
I am grateful that you are much better than Allah and you are much better than Muhammad. Let me give you the bottom line.
On the day of judgment, Allah will forgive you. Who I am? Allah will not forgive Allah. No, I don't say that.
Let me respond to that and I'm going to finish this conversation because you are not listening. So here's the thing. I don't want Allah to forgive me because Allah needs forgiveness. Allah already messed up. His prophet already messed up. But with the death and resurrection of Lord Jesus Christ, you are already forgiven and you don't know and you reject that. And that's going to be very bad for you on the day of judgment. The reason for that is, the moment you deny the work of Lord Jesus Christ, the moment you reject His forgiveness on you, it's already done for you. All I can do is I can continue to pray for you. Then
all in the forgiving case, for what I'm going to try and to sweat and working day and night to get the good work and the good thing and to behave good nicely with people. For what? If I'm forgiving,
I am already forgiven. I am already in love. Therefore, I do it. Islam, I continue to do the thing. Christian, I know. In Islam, you have to work very hard, very hard, and you get nothing. But in Christian faith, Lord Jesus Christ already did everything. It's been done by the blood and resurrection of Lord Jesus Christ.
Who comes to you and tell you that we will not get nothing? We will not find nothing, we will not get nothing. I tell you, no Muslims, no Christians, no, even they don't believe, they know them future in the day of judgment. Just you try.
That is very sad. That is very sad.
No, just you try.
And that must be very hard and scary for you. But by the death and resurrection of Lord Jesus Christ,
only
I
the
know
truth in your side.
Who is
so
waiting for me. I know.
No.
With His death and His resurrection,
right.
I am forgiven.
Yes,
and I know
you
where I am going to be. And
just you believe what your mind say now. Just you believe what your mind say. But you don't know the God in which side. You only believe that the truth in your side.
No.
You yeah.
No.
The truth.
No.
So when you
do you believe?
No,
do
when
you
say
Jesus
that all the Muslims they no,
do you
no,
believe means, Jesus is a liar?
1 minute. When you say that all the Muslims they are working hard and they will get nothing. So what's this?
Muhammad worked very hard. When Muhammad was having sex from one wife to other wife, When Muhammad was trying to jump into the camel, he was working very hard. When Muhammad was killing the people, he was working very hard. But what Allah said to him, ask forgiveness for your past sins and your future sins. And Muhammad said, I don't know where I am going to go. Muhammad didn't know where he's going to go. Muhammad knew his heart was nothing.
So he had to defend himself. I know how
many times
he had to
fight for nothing.
Can you listen?
It's already been done for me, okay? That's the second point. Third point. The moment you deny the work and identity of Lord Jesus Christ, okay? The moment you deny Jesus is the Messiah, Son of God, who died on the cross for my sins, you are Antichrist and you are hurting Jesus' feelings. So, therefore, don't come to me and then say, oh, my feelings are hurt. We will never do the pictures like that so that hurt your feelings. I haven't finished. So, but what you do is, you deny Jesus, you insult Jesus.
No, I don't.
Yeah.
He's the prophet of Allah.
Yeah, that's
I
insult.
Believe. No.
The moment you say, he's just the prophet of Allah, that's insult.
So what?
That's insult. Jesus is the eternal son of
he's
the Father.
The God.
Yeah.
Oh, he's the God. And he sent his son.
Jesus is God. Yes. Jesus is identified as the son of the Father who came to the world and died on the cross for your sins. What did Muhammad do for you?
The God.
What did Muhammad do for you? Nothing.
You believe that Jesus is the God?
Jesus is eternal son of the Father, also is identified as God, yes.
So, and who bring his message, who bring his book to this community, to believe
what
on
book?
Him? Yeah, the Bible. I talk about the Bible.
Bible, so you know what is Bible?
What?
Do you know what is Bible?
Explain to me.
Bible is the basic information before you leave. You need to read it before you leave the earth, okay? 66 books starts from the account of creation. Listen, starts from the account of creation, goes to the when you end up after the day of judgment, okay? Which part? So it is written by 40 different people in minimum 40 different locations within 1,400 years.
1,400 years.
So just a moment. Tell me, what was my answer? Who wrote the Bible?
What
was my answer? Who wrote the Bible?
Yeah, I asked.
No, I answered the question, sir.
You tell me.
I answered your question. What did I say to you? You didn't listen.
You tell me that the Bible is written by 40 persons.
No. Bible is written by 40 different people.
Oh, 40 different
people. 40 different locations within 1,400 years. Okay? So, and in that Bible.
Which one is the right? If wants to be, if someone wants to be Protestant, which one is the right?
Sorry?
If someone, somebody wants to be a Christian.
Yeah.
Which Bible are you going to read?
How many Bibles are there?
You tell me, there is 40 different locations, 40...
I said it is written by 40 different people in 40
different,
in 40 different locations.
Location.
Okay? And here's the Bible, I'll show you. It seems that you never bother to look at it, okay? So if you've got one Bible, why are you asking me such a question?
I read it.
Okay, you read it.
Not all. I started. I get it from John, but...
I'm going to read something to you, and then I want you to tell me what it says, okay? What do you do for a living?
To live it.
Yeah, what do you do? What is your job?
Not yet.
You don't have job?
Yeah.
Have you ever been to hospital?
A hospital? Like what?
Like, have you ever went go to...
Yeah,
you
yeah.
Go to hospital?
Yeah,
okay.
I've been.
Have you ever seen anyone who died in hospital?
Yeah.
So when people go to hospital, are the doctors able to give them eternal life?
What?
When people go to hospital when they are ill, are the doctors capable to give them eternal life?
No.
No.
He just know, we call it in Arabic language, he just know by, science. By science, when he see the biology.
Sentence.
Yeah, yeah. If you are going to die after two...
So, who can give eternal life?
Who can give the life? The God.
So the one who gives life, gives eternal life. Okay,
he
God.
The life and you take it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So God.
Yeah, God.
You can't do that, I can't do that,
yeah.
Doctors can't do that. Okay, listen this.
No human beings can do it.
Listen this. Jesus answered. Follow with me here, okay? Jesus answered. I did tell you, but you do not believe. The miracles I do in my Father's name speak for me, but you do not believe because you are not my sheep. My sheep listen to my voice.
Yeah.
I know them and they follow me. I give them eternal life.
Oh, you talk about the eternal life.
Jesus says, I give them eternal life.
And there
life.
Is a point to Jesus, say that is the God.
Listen, Jesus gives eternal life. You said only God does that, okay? So what is Jesus claiming to be here?
And you give me proof that he gives to someone eternal life.
No. First answer my question.
What
is Jesus claiming to be in here?
He said that I'm going to give the eternal life to who they are following him.
So if Jesus says I am going to give eternal life, okay? And you know as a, you are Muslim, you know Jesus is not a liar.
It's not a lie,
okay.
I can't say.
So, yeah.
No.
So Jesus
no,
says,
no,
listen.
Sorry.
Jesus says,
sorry.
I give eternal life.
It's a lie.
So if Jesus
I
gives eternal
you,
life.
I believe that Jesus is a prophet. Like
but
Muhammad,
you said only God gives
like
eternal life.
Moses.
But
he's
you said
a prophet.
Only God gives eternal life.
Yeah.
Jesus says,
the
I give
Allah
eternal
the
life.
The God who sent the three of them, okay, with a messenger, with a message, the one of the Christian, the Bibles. Moses and a Christian and Jesus than Muhammad the last messenger.
So you said only God gives eternal life. There is nothing indicates in Islam Muhammad gives eternal life. Muhammad couldn't even get his eternal life promise.
No.
And
you
Jesus
know,
says, I give eternal life. What is Jesus claiming to be?
Playing with the intelligence of a human being. If I tell you I'm going to give you eternal life, you know. If I tell you I'm going to
Jesus
give
is not playing with anyone.
No,
when Jesus says,
him.
I give eternal life, Jesus means it and he gives eternal life. With his death and his resurrection,
no,
I am giving eternal life.
I don't talk about him.
You have to talk about
him. I never
assault
him.
I can't give you the reference.
I can't give you the proof that we believe that Jesus is a prophet. Like
Trump,
Jesus.
Give me the proof.
Yeah.
Give me the proof that
I
Jesus is just a
prophet. My mind.
Yeah. Give me the proof.
Yeah.
Give me the proof that Jesus is just a prophet. Can a prophet knows what you are hiding in your house. So, can a prophet know what you are hiding in your fridge. What do you have in your fridge? Jesus is like Adam.
Allah made him from salt.
Sorry, Allah made Adam from what? From dust. From earth. Yeah. So did Allah made Jesus from earth?
Everybody from earth.
Allah made Adam from earth. You know, you are giving me headache. So Allah made Jesus from, Allah made Adam from earth.
Yeah.
Okay? When was the time Allah made Jesus from earth?
Yeah, Jesus from earth.
Like, I thought Jesus was born from like virgin. Surah 19. Jesus was born from virgin.
He's a messenger from Allah.
Listen,
a minute. He's a messenger from Allah. So he's a messenger from Allah, like all the prophets. So he had special miracles, like the other prophets that had them special miracles.
No, let me clear, sir. Shush. Now I need to clear that up. So Allah made Adam from dust. Jesus was born from virgin. Jesus is identified as the spirit of Allah. Becomes spirit of Allah, the word of Allah. Cast into the tummy of Mary, and then born Mary from virgin. Listen, I need you to listen. Bring your ears and listen. I'm saying something very important because it's going to affect your eternity. No, listen. Jesus was born from virgin, identified as spirit from Allah, the word of Allah, cast in the tummy of Mary, and then Mary gave birth to Jesus while she was virgin. Jesus, according to your Quran, knows what people are hiding in their homes. According to your Quran, I haven't finished. According to your Quran, Jesus is all knowing. According to your Quran, Jesus is still alive. I need you to shush. I need you to shush. You are not listening to what I'm saying.
Of Allah to Mary. To Maryam, so, and I give you the proof from Quran.
That so you are not listening, I am done with you.
No,
tell me what I told you.
Yeah,
tell me what I told you. So you didn't listen. Listen carefully. Jesus was born from virgin. Jesus is the spirit of Allah, the word of Allah, cast in the tummy of Mary, okay? Jesus is all-knowing according to Islam. Jesus knows what people are hiding in their houses. Jesus gives life to dead people. Jesus is seated with Allah on his throne. Okay? So, according to Islam, Jesus is not just a messenger.
So, you believe that Jesus is God? You?
My scripture first.
You believe that Jesus is God? So, why you tell me the other story, that the Quran story, that is spiritual?
According to Quran, Jesus is much more than a messenger.
No, I tell you.
Which messenger in the Quran identified as the word of Allah? Which messenger in the Quran identified as all knowing? Which messenger in the Quran is with Allah while Allah is running the universe? Which one?
I give you the proof.
Give me the name.
59 from Al-Umra. Talk about that. He's like Adam. He's coming. He's the son of Adam, like all the human beings.
Is Adam died?
Yeah, I show you
the proof. Did Adam die?
What?
Did Adam die?
Yeah.
Did Jesus die?
Yeah.
You believe Jesus died?
Yeah, died.
You believe Jesus died?
Yeah, he died.
How did he die?
Yeah, he died.
How did he die?
One minute.
How did Jesus die?
Can I talk?
I want to answer the question.
Okay. Okay, no problem.
Fuck the Israeli government.
Sir? How did Jesus die?
I told you, sister, if you want what Quran say and what Islam say about...
I want you to tell me, how did Jesus die?
Yeah, he died. He died.
How? He got
the
old
Jewish
and died?
Should I kill him?
Sorry?
The Islamic story that the Jewish people, they killed Jesus.
So according to Islam, Jesus was killed by Jews?
Yeah.
Are you sure?
But they say who he is. They think that he is. They put him in that
cross.
They cross him. They put him in cross. But they think he's that. They think that he's staying in that cross. He goes to next to his God.
So they believe that he died, but he didn't die. So you just
no,
you
they
just
believe that.
Him.
No, no,
you
I talk about the Jews.
By saying they killed him, but actually they didn't kill him.
I tell you about Jesus, what the Jesus believes. They think that when they put him in the cross, I can give you the ayat and the surah. I have the proof from Quran that when they do it with him and they cross him, they think that he's. They think that they hurt him, but he go next to Allah, next to the
so
God.
He didn't die. Did he die or he didn't die?
He died.
He died.
He died. Yeah.
Okay. And where is he now?
What? Where all the people waiting for the day of judgment?
Surah 4, verse 158.
I can give you the
Surah 4, verse 158.
Yeah.
Tells us Jesus is with Allah. Okay?
1 minute.
And it implies that Jesus never died. Here's the bottom line, okay? You are just wasting my time by not listening. There is very serious issue here. The one you are denying, okay? The one you don't even want to talk about, and the one you discredit and you mocked him by denying what he did on the cross and by denying his identity, is going to judge you on the day of judgment. I'm listening what I'm saying to you. Surah 4 verse 157. I know what you are reading. I know what you are reading. Read verse 158.
They don't cross him. They put him on the cross, but it's like imagination. They think that they hate him and they cross him, but what I can should be alone. They're thinking it's a fake thinking.
So who is thinking that?
You talk about the
who is
Jewish.
Thinking?
Jewish. Jewish, yeah.
Who is making them to think?
Allah
is making them to think that they killed him, but they didn't kill him.
Yeah.
So Allah deceived
like
people. Allah punished Jews by making them to think that they killed Jesus while they didn't kill Jesus.
1 minute.
Allah is a liar. Allah is a deceiver. Stay away from Islam. Stay away from Islam.
No, I tell you what's the truth. That's the real Islamic story about Jews.
Islam is awful ideology. So far I've been talking to you for last half an hour. Islam is an ideology tells you beat your wife. Islam is an ideology where your prophet beat his wife. Islam is an ideology that teaches you go and kill your mother if your mom give up Islam.
No,
Islam
wrong.
Is an ideology
I
denies
you,
the
you,
identity and work of Lord you. Jesus Christ. And Islam is the same ideology.
No.
Wash your brain and your heart. All I can do is Lord Jesus Christ, open your heart and open your mind, sir. I'm done with you. He's not only a prophet. He's more than that. He's a Messiah. He's the eternal son of the Father. He's the Alpha and Omega. He's the King of Kings, Lord of Lords. He's the one who is going to come and judge you.
I believe. I don't insult him. He's a prophet. He's a messenger from Allah.
That's assault. That's insult.
No, it's not assault.
No, it is. You deny who he is. That's assault. And that hurts my feeling.
The place I do not live. How can I be a God? Then I stand myself.
Because you are not God.
What?
He is the Son. Father is the one who is sending the Son.
No, I ask you, he's a God. You tell me he's a God. So how that Son is coming? How the Son is coming?
Christians believe in one God, and this God is identified as Father, Son, and Spirit. Father, listen. You ask the question, now listen. Okay, I've been very generous to you and listening all the lies you are telling
me. Thank you very much.
And now you need to focus. I'm telling you about my God. Okay? Father is the one who is sending the Son. And Son is the one who is willing to come and give himself people like you and people like me. And you are making mockery of that. Not acceptable. Repent. You've got to repent. Your eternity is pretty shaky and in very, very bad place. If you do not believe Jesus is the Messiah, if you do not believe Jesus is the eternal Son of the Father, you do not get eternal life.
I believe that he is a prophet.
If you're stuck with that, you won't get eternal life.
He's like Moses. He's
he's not like Moses. Yeah. He's more than a Moses.
Sorry. You believe that he's your God. This is your own point. So I expect
it's not about my point.
No,
you don't see the point. Point is, with your rejection, you are putting yourself into hell. You are denying the work of God. You are denying his heart and his love towards you.
Protecting ourselves.
Protecting yourself by making yourself to get the hell, if that's the place you want. Good for you. Good for you.
If paradise, and you are no.
Jesus is the Messiah and the Son of the Father. If you do not believe that, you don't get eternal life. That is the bottom line, sir.
That you get paradise. Yeah.
It's not I am get the paradise. I am getting God himself. God who give himself for me. I am going to get him. It's not only I am getting his righteousness. It's not only he's taking my crown of sin, but he gives himself to me and I am getting him. That's all I am longing for. The one who I am worshipping, at the end, I am going to get that one, sir. I'll see you another time.